When I finally got to Ox House, yo, there was cops everywhere. I seen that nigga laid out. The fucking top dog with his throat slit from ear to ear. Damn. Yo, I drove around Queens for like an hour and a half in a daze. Finally, I drove up through Rosedale Projects. Me and Buns used to hang out there back in the days. That's where all the bitches was. Yo, when I walked through, I saw my man Shorty out there pumping. Shorty was like 12 going on 20. A real loser type nigga, you know? No hope for the future at all. To him, it just wasn't realistic that he was ever going to make it out the projects. And he was right.
What up, Shorty? Man, niggas up mad early getting that paper, huh?
Y'all got bagged, son.
What happened?
Thursday, I got bagged.
Boy, what happened,
fucking
son?
With this nigga on the fucking roof, man.
On the roof?
Yeah, man.
What you doing?
Shot this nigga, man. And I got still burning, man. Shit's just getting hot. See? It's got whole shit down. You know what I'm saying? Got the bulletproof vest.
Yo, damn, man.
Shit's just hot.
Yo, man. Don't let these niggas out here stare you wrong, man. See them niggas on the corner over there? Still gonna be out here forever, man. Yo, man. Fucking with guns. When you fuck with guns, Shorty, it's always the coolest niggas that fuck around and get murdered, you know? It's a war out here. Mad niggas is dying. You don't want that shit to be you, right?
Nah.
I know you're gonna hold it down, though. You know what I mean? Just be careful, man. These niggas out here ain't even really worth it.
You're an ill nigga, though. I like your style, son.
Shorty, I'm a ghost, all right? Look in your pocket, though. That's you. That's for me, baby. Just make sure you rise above all this madness out here. Mind elevation, man. Fuck that petty shit. You don't need it. For real. All right?
All right, my nigga. You're out, dickhead. Open the gate.
Buns was an animal out the cage, for real. But he went around the way to lay at his stepmom's crib and get his plans together. And that's where life as he knew it came to an end.
All right, here we go. Oh, oh. Yeah, right there. Oops. Try that one on. Here it is, man.
What you, a coach or something? I know you ain't from around here.
I'm Roger. How you doing, Tommy? Now, I just came looking for you, man.
Looking for me for what?
When I heard that police finally had you in custody, I wanted to come down and just meet you in person. Don't get nervous. A lot of agents here. So what I think you should do is just pay attention and listen to me. Listen to what I'm going to tell you. I'm gonna give you a choice, man.
Well, I got a choice?
Yeah, you got a choice. I'm gonna offer you some freedom. You know, you're in a lot of trouble. Without us, you go to jail. You go to jail forever. You understand?
So who I gotta bless?
He calls himself the minister. It's your job to get into his organization and learn his ways. On New Year's Eve, he's having the biggest gathering, World's Day of Reckoning, at the Armory in Harlem. On that very night, we will terminate this fucker. We'll do everything in our power to help you. We'll give you all the help that's necessary. But be warned, we got a lot of operatives in place. And if you show any weakness, or if you betray us, it'll be your resignation. You understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Don't fuck around, Bones.
But you know, for real, I was thinking. I mean, I know it's your boy, and I hate to keep bringing it up. But seriously, we need to start thinking about us. Because this shit's too dangerous now.
Yo,
it's
see,
not safe anymore.
See, I feel like it's time for us to, like, go away from here, you know what I mean? I've been thinking about it for a long time.
Well, where will we go?
T, let's go to Africa.
Shit, nigga, please, be for real.
Yo, I've never been more serious in my life. I mean, we've been to the islands, we've been everywhere. Who says we can't go to Africa?
I don't know. Africa's far.
So what? I'm saying, just think about us. That's all we ever talk about. That's our dream, to go to our homeland, where our roots are. Fuck it, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, forget about money. Fuck everything. It's a chance of a lifetime. If me and you went, and a baby, yo, just think. Maybe it's the right thing to do, maybe not.
Well, I'll think about it. I will think about it.
Buns was supposed to take out the minister. Apparently, they needed a nigga to do it for publicity or something. And Tommy was perfect. He had to start from the bottom, though, you know, really take it serious with the religion. He had to study and really be a part of it, because it wasn't going to be easy to get close to the minister. Meanwhile, Knowledge and Shamik started scheming on how they was going to find Bundy, you know, for a little payback visit. And Knowledge knew where Keisha lived, so he knew Tommy wouldn't be far behind. Oddly enough, the more Tommy got into character, the more, you know, the truth is like the light. And no matter what clouds are true, eventually the sun will come out. And you cannot stop the sun from shining. For the first time, the sun was finally shining on Bundy.
Relax, shorty. Nobody here to fuck with you. Fucked up.
Why don't you get your stank ass out my motherfucking house and take your broke ass niggas with you?
We just here looking for this naked adult, and we was hoping maybe Seth could tell us where to find this ass.
Uh-uh.
Oh, shit.